infested with living organisms, any more than your skeleton is bones infested with cells. The Earth is geological, yes, but this geological entity grows people. And so the existence of people is symptomatic of the kind of universe we live in.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. Yeah.
just as the waves are continuous with the ocean, your body is continuous with the total energy system of the cosmos. And it's all you. We have this hostility to the external world because of the superstition, the myth, the absolutely unfounded theory that you yourself exist only inside your skin. Now, I want to propose another idea altogether. Is a result of the Big Bang, on the end of the process. You are still the process. You are the Big Bang, the original force of the universe, coming on as whoever you are. See, when I meet you, I see not just what you define yourself as, Mr. So-and-so, Miss So-and-so, Mrs. So-and-so. I see every one of you as the primordial energy of the universe coming on at me in this particular way. I know I'm that too.
could listen to sound and realize that that is the whole point of being alive. To go with this particular energy manifestation, to be it.
Every one of us, fundamentally, deep inside, let's put it that way, is an act of, a function of, a performance of, a manifestation of the works. The whole blinking cosmos, with all its galaxies, and forever and ever and ever, whatever it is beyond that,
thank you.
of a state which you call is, or reality, or life, this implies another state called isn't. At the same time as being a form of awareness and sensitivity and understanding, it's also a form of ignorance. The ordinary everyday consciousness that we have leaves out more than it takes in. And because of this, it leaves out things that are terribly important. It leaves out things that would, if we did know them, allay our anxieties and fears and horrors, we would have a deep interior peace. Now, the question that is absolutely basic for all human beings is, what have you left out?